We're waking up to another word that's being banned.
Yeah.
Basically, it's a TRL, MTV's, you know, hit show there, Total Request Live, has banned the word suicide.
Suicide.
From Sean Kingston's just massive hit song.
Isn't that a big part of the song?
Yeah. Yeah, it's Beautiful Girls. Beautiful Girls. I even know this
beautiful
song.
Beautiful Girls.
Because my 7-year-old niece sings it, and she loves the part where it goes, suicide, suicidal, or whatever.
Yeah.
But, well, you know, MTV and TRL has decided that, can't have that. So they're banning the word suicide from this hit song. And now you got us, like, sitting here, you know, on the radio going, it is insane, though.
Yeah.
You can't ban words. Stop. Oops. Just stop already.
Drop my iPhone.
Oh, boy.
Good thing it's got the rubber baby buggy bumpers on it. Yeah, stop with the banning words.
Especially in this day and age, because the internet is becoming more and more powerful. We all know that. Most of us are spending probably more time on our computers than watching TV.
Yep.
And TV's in a weird situation right now. You know, they're scared S-less of the internet. I mean, you watch TV on a regular basis, and they're pushing their own websites now and everything.
They're trying to make some of these shows look like you're watching the web.
Right, right.
Like, there's that one... it starts with an I, of course, because everything internet has to start with an I. And they show clips. It's like a clip show.
Yeah.
Of internet stuff. Why am I watching that on TV? Why don't I just go to the internet?
It's funny that you know, TV was so far behind as far as the internet goes, and now they're trying to play catch up, and they're scared, man. I mean, I watched The Insider, that dumb gossip show about all the, you know, what's going on in Hollywood and stuff.
Yeah,
and they don't do their whole show anymore. They'll leave one or two stories and go, if you want to find out what's going on with this, go to theinsider.com or whatever the hell it's called.
Yep.
You know, they're pushing.
Driving traffic.
They're trying to drive their own traffic to their own websites because they understand this is major competition at this point. Mm-hmm. So I don't understand MTV's logic to actually start banning words when people already are looking at TV like it's lame.
Because they're the same dummies that didn't see this coming to begin with. So now that these dummies are trying to push people to their dumb shows on the internet, they're still showing you TV versions on the internet.
Right.
Nobody, my girlfriend and I are watching some Shark Week, which we like.
Mm-hmm.
We were watching some old Shark Weeks on the DVD set we got when they came in. And they were showing shark reenactments. There's some really good footage of shark attacks. But occasionally they show you the reenactment, which is just, it's bubbles,
yeah.
And then red stuff in the water.
Red stuff, yeah.
And like a bad fin that obviously somebody's just shaking with their hand.
In the water.
Red stuff, fin shake.
Yeah.
And she's like, I don't want to see reenactments. And I'm like, you can't watch a reenactment anymore when you can go online and find all of the real shark attack videos, which they'll show a lot of on Shark Week, but they'll cut some of the truly graphic stuff.
Well, this is the point with MTV, though. I mean, the people that would watch TRL, what's the age group, seriously? 12 to pushing 20, maybe?
Yeah.
Okay, those people are you know, really understand the internet. So if you turn around and say, well, we're going to bleep suicide from this Sean Kingston song, these people, that demo, they're gone, man. They're going to go on the internet and go, oh, you guys are so effing lame. I don't need you anymore. And the ratings for TRL are drastically dropping over the last few years. Someone else is pointing out that Linkin Park's song, they bleep out the word noose and bleed it out. This is just stupid, stupid programming.
Especially MTV's audience. I mean, like, words like noose and suicide. How is your target audience supposed to know how to deal with their problems? I mean, that's the answer. We all know that. When things are too bad, you stick your head in an oven. I don't understand why MTV would remove that option.
Is there a song with oven in it?
Probably not.
That's for the older demo.
It really is. If you're over 70 and you want to off yourself, find an oven and stick your head in it.
Pillow.
What is MTV doing?
Major League Baseball doesn't use suicide squeeze term anymore.
It's
not true.
We're just a bunch
Adam.
Of Americans are a bunch of phonies.
Adam, where'd you get that?
You know what? I actually read it in the paper this year, and I heard it on a Fox broadcast. They don't call it a suicide squeeze. They call it a sacrifice squeeze now.
A sacrifice squeeze. It was called a suicide squeeze.
We're here at
and how many people
Fox are calling it a homicide squeeze to take the attention off of the suicide person and
What purpose does that serve? How many people off themselves because some dumb baseball announcer said suicide squeeze?
Yeah.
We're losing our minds.
That's a good idea.
Yeah.
Either want to kill myself or have some fresh squeezed orange juice.
Right.
Every time one person has a bad reaction to a word, the rest of the people go, "Ah, we shouldn't say that anymore.
Mm-hmm.
That's bad."
Well, here's Sean Kingston. Just to, you know, this is the song. It's huge.
Hey, y'all. Sean Kingston.
You're way too beautiful, girl.
Just a clip, don't worry.
That's why yeah, really. You never work. You have me suicidal, suicidal. When you say it's over, damn all these beautiful girls. They only wanna do your dirt. They'll have you suicidal, suicidal.
I love the song, Reverend Al. The good one.
I wondered what would happen if they would sing Calypso over the Stand By Me beat.
Yeah, exactly.
That song is massive, and that part of the song is the whole song. That's the hook that everyone sings. This is what MTV did with it.
Hey, yo, Sean Kingston.
You're way too beautiful, girl. That's why it'll never work. You'll have me. When you say it's over, damn all these beautiful
Are you kidding me?
Girls, they only want to do you dirt, they'll have you.
It's official, MTV sucks! And I know we work for the same company. You guys are so stupid. You don't even know how stupid you are. The internet is nipping at your heels, and you're doing this crap on TV.
You're popping in dead air.
We don't work for the same company.
What?
We don't work for the same company.
Ah, no. Sort of. It's all sort of connected.
We spun off.
All right, then good. Because I was like, oh boy, this is.
But what are they doing? You're right, dude. The internet. It's the same mentality.
What?
They're getting their teeth kicked in by cable, and they don't look at the tools because they're so arrogant. People that's in, like, whether it's just radio or whether it's television, they're so arrogant that they don't think anything is going to come and pass them by, at least not in the current administration's lifetimes, so they don't have to worry about it. But now that it's creeping up faster than they saw, they're panicking, and they're sending people to their awful sites, like you just said, and it's just watered-down, emasculated drivel on the net. Nobody wants to see that on the net.
No.
And if you went to their website, you'd hear the same thing.
Let me make this perfectly clear once again. That is the whole song. That's not just a tiny little part of the song that you maybe could get away with. That is the hook.
So there's a crap load of dead air in there.
Crap load of, yes. Yes. Because we only played like a quick snippet, obviously.
Can I say good?
How stupid is TV getting?
Good for Sean Kingston's people because they gave him the option of putting in denial. I think that's a lyric. They actually have an alternate lyric. Yeah. So MTV gave them the option of submitting the one that has in denial or of having it dropped.
Yeah.
And they said, drop it.
And by the way,
we're not going to change what we're doing.
And you know, every year they have like the summer song. Sean, this song is probably the summer song this year. And
I'd love to know who the person is, the one person that made that decision.
I guarantee you, it's abroad in standards and practices.
Yeah.
Well, here's
where she has fat calves and fat ankles, and she wears like a suit that's a little bit too tight for her. Woman's business suit. They don't want to admit that they're 35 and their fat hips are bulging out. I guarantee that that's who pushed this.
Hey, here's the official statement from a spokeswoman for MTV.
Oh, there you go. Mm-hmm. Of course.
Because we know suicide is an issue that so many members of our audience struggle with, we do not take any references to suicide lightly.
Yeah, but it's somebody's, like, you know, whether you like it or not, it's somebody's art. You know, and they're kind of, that word that he wrote in there, is there for a reason.
Same thing.
Feeling suicidal. Like, why not
put
it into a song?
But they have no problem showing young broads, like, dressed in nothing, shaking their hips.
Isn't that great?
That's okay. That's not influencing women, you dopes.
Back to 1982 with Suicide Solution.
It's so selective with this crap.
Ozzy Osbourne, Suicide Solution. A couple of kids kill themselves because they misinterpret the lyrics of the song. Because it's actually a song about Bon Scott and alcoholism. And a couple of dummies blow their heads off because they don't understand what the song is really trying to tell them, which is don't drink.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden, Suicide Solution is to blame. It's the same thing 25 years later.
Same crap.
Here we go. MTV says it doesn't have a list of words that are automatically censored, but instead consider everything contextually.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Ugh.
Well, that context seems to be the safest of any. It's in a song. It's not being thrown around in an irresponsible way.
Well, this is. I'm so excited about the internet. I'm so excited that you can now watch, you know, videos and everything else, and
yep.
the quality is right there. You don't have to wait forever to download nothing anymore. What scares me though is all this crap is going to go to the internet next, where there's going to have all sorts of standards and
it's a lot harder.
I'm hoping, man. I'm hoping
because the internet's all underground. You know, that's where most of your good stuff is.
I'm hoping,
and there's so many offshore sites. The only problem is they can block stuff from coming in.
Yeah,
eventually, I think he's right. They will be. They will. Do that. I mean, they will block objectionable sites and.
Great.
And God bless Michael Harrison. He's fighting the good fight. He works for Talkers Magazine. He's had a lot of things to say about us. He's always supported us in our problems. He says, as far as this subject goes, commercial television is usually more sensitive about political correctness and obscenity and raw language than radio. Radio is usually more aggressive and more reflective of street mentality. Some stations do run the edited in-denial version of Kingston's song, but warns Harrison, anytime you start censoring art, you're heading down the slippery slope towards censoring political speech because art is a form of political speech.
Hmm.
Where does it end?
It really is amazing how people have found a way to take away what you want to say, and yet they say, well, no, we're not censoring your
freedom. No, it's not your freedom of speech.
It's just because of this.
Yeah.
It's like back in 1750, if you wanted to say certain things, well, no, we're not censoring you, of course. We're the forefathers, but we just don't think that Negroes should vote or be free. So don't
right.
say that because it's objectionable to what our group mentality is.
Yeah.
And it's great, the big wigs at MTV, like, I don't understand why the ratings went down.
What happened?
They're dropping. Where's everyone going?
Maybe we ought to play those. When were our ratings really huge?
Right.
Okay, start playing Tubes videos again.
Right.
And Blue Oyster Cult.
Where are they going? Your audience is pretty smart. And if they're not getting what they want from your dumb, you know, show, they're going to go to the internet.
Yep.
They're going to the internet. This is not the time to go uber conservative with your crap.
There's an alternative. There's another option out there that wasn't out there years ago.
You know who's ruining it? Lawyers.
Mm.
The same lawyers we've had to sit and meet with are the same girls who they'll have to meet with. Not even the same guy, the same person, but the same mentality.
We could be held liable right. if somebody does commit suicide and the parents deem that they were watching MTV and that song came could be that we could be held liable.
You want to hear that dead air again?
Yeah, that's a good one.
They don't want to do their jobs and defend the companies. So all they do is tell companies how to be pussies and not get yelled at. That's what lawyers do now. They don't tell companies how we'll defend you. It's be a pussy and let's not get yelled at all.
Yeah.
Why do they make the same point twice? I don't know.
I love hearing just the dead air with just the lame music in the background.
That air's great.
The hit song of the summer, and this is what they did to it. What dopes.
Hey, yo, Sean Kingston.
You're way too beautiful, girl.
Beautiful.
That's why it'll never work. You have me.
You have me what?
Lean on me.
You have me what? Say what? You have me what?
Damn all these beautiful girls. They only want to do you dirt. They'll have you.
Have you what? Have you what?
They say it's
all. I feel unsatisfied. See,
all they do is
and that's a real emotion, by the way, to be suicidal. When you get that just that despair over something.
Oh.
You're like, oh. Oh, I want her. She doesn't want me. I'm
nothing I can do about
right.
it.
They just put more emphasis on the word by removing it.
Yeah.
All you've done is go, what is that?
It's like, what word did they cut out? And then you have it not in context. You have it just alone sitting there going, suicidal. That's the word that got taken out.
And this is the equivalent of what they've done. We don't like that word, so we're going to print out the lyrics, but we're going to put suicidal in red.
Yeah.
This way you won't look at it. You'll just go right by it.
That's pretty much what they did, yeah.
Hey, is My Sweet 16 on MTV or VH1? MTV. I think that has little girls killing themselves way more than a Sean Kingston song. Showing little girls all over America what they can't have ever, 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 ever,
yeah.
ever, ever.
Daddy bought me a Lexus.
I think that would bring some people to suicide. Oh, it's just insane. It really is. I don't get this on any level. I'm sorry. And I never will. Never will. All right, we got to take a quick break. We got tickets, man. We got the big show Saturday.
Do we?
Got the big show Saturday. The PNC is the big get as far as this comedy tour goes.
Although, be the biggie.
Although all the cities have been just unbelievable. The reviews on the show have been unbelievable. The fans have been coming out in droves. But last year, we, I don't know, we did like, what, 11,000 tickets at the PNC, something like that? And we're heading toward that again this year. We got a pair of tickets to the Virus Tour at the PNC Bank Arts Center this Saturday, courtesy of Blades of Glory on DVD, in stores everywhere, Tuesday, August 28th. We'll take a random caller, so we got to hang up on everybody that had comments about this.
Sorry.
Sorry about that. I'm hanging up on everybody. Sorry.
Sorry, I want to apologize to those callers.
All right, a random caller gets tickets to the show this Saturday. Go to Virus Tour, one word on MySpace for all the info. But give us a call, 877-212-O-N-A. It's Opie and Anthony. Hey, the instant feedback going crazy after that last break where we found out today that MTV, their good old TRL show, is censoring the word suicide and suicidal out of the smash hit from Sean Kingston. Spectro from Michigan writes, how many people are struggling with it? Maybe instead they should ban Dunkin' Donut commercials. Spectro again, sounds like a job for the past. How about if we send in our version of the MT version? By filling in the dead air. Hey, that's not a bad idea.
Something more offensive.
That's not a bad idea. And then Rex from Houston writes, thank you, MTV, for protecting me from that evil word. I'm so glad I can't think for myself. Just some of the instant feedback coming in this morning. And now we got a whole list of things that MTV has done. Censoring music videos, taking words out. It's unbelievable, actually. You got a copy of this, Jimmy?
I do. And again, the artist can always say, no, we don't want to submit it. But the artist, you know.
Then, how are they going to say no to this, though? They need their exposure.
Yeah, you need your videos being played.
You know, and well, they could say no more now because the internet is finally, you know, getting to a place where they're getting some nice exposure with their craft. Which one you want to do here? There's a million examples of MTV censoring.
Some of these are ridiculous. One of the first ones, they said, apparently the words, we taken over, had the two words work and supply censored in this line. If you want, we can supply, got enough work to feed the whole town. I'm supposing those are drug references.
Who would know?
I know.
I like the, hash pipe, Weezer's hash pipe. Remember that?
Yep.
The word hash was all obscured.
I love this one. The old apartment video by Bare Naked Ladies had a scene removed where the protagonist rips the telephone off the wall.
What?
I don't know.
That was my old, that's what my daddy did after he threw the spaghetti against the wall.
Weezer.
My life should have been edited.
Too violent.
Yeah, Weezer, we are all on drugs. We are all on drugs.
Yeah.
Was changed to We Are All In Love.
Of course.
Which completely just changes the entire song.
Of course it does. Just silly geese.
Uh-huh. What else? Stinkfist by Tool.
Jesus, man. Yeah.
Stinkfist by Tool was renamed track number one since the title was considered too offensive for public consumption. What else? What other ones pop out at you guys here?
System of Down's first video, Sugar, was also their most censored video. As it censored the words mushroom, Russian, and anger, besides the usual censoring of the F word in the song.
Let me ask you about this.
Russian.
I'm sorry, man. I didn't mean
to. That's okay.
I'm just thinking about people who have been multiple times accused of pedophilia and gotten away with it. Michael Jackson's single, They Don't Care About Us, MTV has replaced the words Jew me and kike me with do me and strike me. In the line, Jew me, sue me, kick me, kike me, don't you black or white me. According to Jackson, the song had words to describe prejudice, and it was poor judgment to select Jewish people as explanatory words. My thing is, why as an artist, and this is just hitting me, is he doing that? And even though they censored him, there's no public outrage. There's no protests about racism.
No.
Why as an artist is it deemed acceptable by blacks for Michael Jackson to use that as an example of racism in his art? Why is Imus not considered an artist who used race in his art, but Michael Jackson is? Just another example. Black people.
Do me and kike me. Do me, strike me. Now you can say that. I don't care. I will not defend certain people.
Yeah, very selective on who's
very
gonna,
selective
on who he's going to defend. What an idiot! Hey, here's my favorite right here. Remember this song?
Well, let me get to the point. Let's roll another joint. Turn around.
Yeah. They wouldn't say joint.
Huh?
They took the word joint and reversed it.
Well, let me get to the point. Let's roll.
What the hell is that?
You two-gooders are ruining everything.
I really think it's about the lawyers. I really think that everybody is so sue happy. Oh, they're like, you know what? We're not getting sued for it, and the lawyers will never just take that out. Just take that out. Take that reference out.
Well, when are the lawyers going to be held responsible? When are the lawyers going to be held responsible when all the ratings drop for all these shows on TV and the ratings drop for popular radio shows? When are they held responsible and lose their jobs? That's what I asked today.
Never.
Because we sit through these meetings, and they make our lives a living hell and make it harder and harder to broadcast on a regular basis, and they just go about collecting huge paychecks. And they'll continue doing their job long after we're gone with another show here.
Mm-hmm.
When are they held responsible? And someone goes, you know what, dude, you're taking this too far. You're fired.
Yep.
Fire a lawyer. Wake them up.
You're fired.
How often do people sue for like their kids killing themselves and actually win with a company? It's like, don't you think the money you're paying these lawyers every year is less than you'd have to pay to the... It's almost like when a car company comes out with a defect.
Yeah.
A lot of times they do a cost-effective thing. Do we leave the defect in and take the lawsuits that come with the injuries?
Mm-hmm.
Will that be more or less expensive than recalling all the cars and fixing the defect?
I know. I saw Fight Club.
Yeah. That wasn't Fight Club. I didn't see that in Fight... I never saw Fight Club.
Oh, no?
That was in the Gene Hackman movie where he was a lawyer and his daughter was the opposing lawyer. You know,
oh, I saw it in Fight Club.
Yeah.
Really?
Where Edward Norton describes it while he's sitting in the plane.
Oh, never saw it.
Yeah.
Oh, you've never seen Fight Club?
No, I've not.
Are you crazy?
Oh, Jimmy.
Never saw it.
Really?
You love Fight Club.
Yes, you did.
I swear to God, I've never seen Fight Club.
Although the book is way better.
Is it? Okay,
see the movie first.
No, read the book first.
No, that ruins
movie
it.
Movie first, always.
No. Movie first, always.
No.
Something like that, you got to see the movie first.
I watched the movie while reading the book quickly.
Yes, that's another way to do it.
You try to keep up?
Yeah.
Watch the movie, but read happy endings while you're watching it.
Ooh.
How about that?
There you go.
I'll be signing it in Boston this Thursday. Thank you.
No problem. Really, Jimmy?
I like sliding in like that.
Another fine Boston visit for little Jimmy Norton?
I believe this will be the final signing I do. It's at Barnes & Noble. I got so many emails from Boston, they were annoyed that I didn't actually do Boston. So 6 o'clock this Thursday, Barnes & Noble on the Prudential Center, and I'll be on Toucher and Rich on our fine station, BCN. Mm. 4 p.m. Finally get to go up and do radio with those guys.
Boylston Street. The Barnes & Noble on Boylston Street. Cool. Very cool. Let's say hi to Ron in Jersey. Ron? What's up?
Yeah, I just want to remind you guys. You remember Beavis and Butthead?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah, you don't remember none of that.
What?
I don't remember that show.
Hey, you remember
it was one of the greatest shows ever.
Some little douche pyromaniac decided to light his house on fire, and then they totally ruined one of the best bits they ever did.
Yeah, they blamed it on Beavis saying fire. And made it so Beavis couldn't say fire anymore. They censored a cartoon character.
Well, did Beavis, did they lose a lawsuit or no?
I don't know if they lawsuit or not.
Yeah, I don't know.
Don't know if it was settled or something like that, but they were definitely blaming the cartoon because the kid would walk around going, fire, fire, fire. And then the kid lit himself on fire somehow.
Best bit they ever did.
All right,
guys, punch it out, thanks.
I like how they took care of it one time. They take jabs at that. One time, there was a broken pipe, and Beavis just started going, water, water, water. It's not as fun. This isn't as fun.
Let's go to Colorado. Eric?
What the hell are you doing?
Eric?
Morning, boys.
Good morning, Eric.
Hey, the theme music to MASH is all about suicide.
Yes.
A couple weeks ago, I was in the original movie.
Yes.
Hold on, Eric. You got to slow down a little bit.
So we're yesing.
Wait, it's a little give and take here.
You have to say that again now. Just say, what is the...
Start over.
What is the MASH theme music about?
It's about suicide.
Yes! Of course!
I love that.
Thank you.
Got it.
Anyhow, a couple of weeks ago, I was watching the movie, and the part where they are... playing the song and singing it, all of the words were gone. It was just the music, and it completely ruins the movie when they do that.
Oh. What the, wait, so...
Oh. The creepy vocals.
Yes! Rosemary and Thyme.
Shh. Don't play that.
That's terrific. That's terrific.
Hippie crap.
I like this, though.
Goddamn hippies.
Oh, my God. I could listen to that all day.
It is great. So much, by the way, it's actually much more recognizable without the lyrics. Like, the beat is more famous than the song with the lyrics.
So, yeah. Eric, what channel played the MASH movie and edited that out?
You know what? I don't remember. I think I want to say it was FX, but it might have been one of the other channels.
Facts. I doubt it was FX. They probably made them put more suicide references in.
Yeah.
I had no idea that suicide was one of these words. One of these words. Words hurt.
It's amazing how suicide has nothing to do with people listening to lyrics. It's
yeah, hearing the
idiocy.
Words. And
all right, thank you.
How about this little tune?
Yeah.
Everybody, yeah. Everybody, yeah. Get into it. Yeah. Get stoked. Get retarded. Get retarded. Get retarded.
Get retarded.
This was the theme song for the retarded Laverne Shirley when they would come on our show.
Let's get retarded in hell.
Yeah.
Well, now it's now it's this.
Get it started.
Wow.
Yeah. I'm sorry, your son has started.
That's what we're going to do, you know, as a society. All these do-gooders out there trying to ban all these words, you know, and I'm talking about all races, all colors, all everybody.
Yeah.
We're just going to come up with new words.
That's, new words.
That's just human nature, man.
New words that hurt.
New words that hurt. That's what we're going to do.
We need version 2.0 of words that hurt.
That's what it comes down to in the end. We're not going to change as human beings. We're going to always make fun of people that don't look like us or think like us.
You know what really got me also? It ties into the tragic story of the two firefighters that were killed over at the Ground Zero in that stupid building over there.
Yeah, for the rest of America, we had a huge fire over the weekend, I guess, and we lost two, man.
Yeah.
We lost two guys.
A damn drag. But I was reading the transcripts of the radio communication between the firemen and command and the guys that were outside the building, and just... really compelling and horrifying transcripts of what these guys are going through inside there. And there's a lot of use of what are deemed bad words. You know, bad words.
Seriously? What words? Yeah, I haven't read this transcript.
The S word, you know. It's the way people really talk in real life situations. You cannot be in a more real life situation than that. You know, and these are professionals. These are professional people doing their job that they know is dangerous. They know how to do it to the best of their ability. And they're still using these words. So why is it so bad to have them used in certain places and certain other contexts when it's being used every day? I mean, you know, you go, I'm sure you go up to Capitol Hill, you'll hear that word a lot. I'm sure you hear a lot of other words. But for some reason, we have this illusion. These people have this illusion that they think no one's using these words. They're never being used. Take them out of movies. Don't put them in video games. Don't do this. Don't use them on the radio or TV. We're upset that we have to see, Rescue Me. They use them on bad words all the time on that, what's considered bad words. It's on FX. And people get upset about it. It's like, that's the way people talk. You want realism? That's the way people talk.
When you look at European commercials and Americans, one thing Americans love to do is we love to deny who we are.
Mm-hmm.
We love denying that. Like, for a long time, we denied we were racist, but we, you know, blacks couldn't vote, and yet, you know, in the 50s, it was still like apple pie and mom, and
yeah,
it was great in this country. We just like to deny our sexual desires. That's why when you look at European commercials, they'll make sexual references or innuendos or be very funny, and we don't do any of that. You know, it's always the empowered gal waving her shoes. I bring home the bacon, bub. And that's what Americans do. We really are fraudulent, man. It's really beginning to annoy me. As a country, we're just phony.
Yeah.
Deny who we are and what we like.
Hey, can I jump in here? Another reason just to find the local radio station to listen to the Opie and Anthony show. XM is screwing up more and more lately. You know that whole "Let's get retarded, let's get it started" and the MASH theme with the lyrics. No one on the XM side heard it. So just tune over to your local station because they got it all figured out. I don't know why. I'm sick of trying to figure out
why.
The phones are echoey at times. I don't know.
Wait, that's ridiculous.
That's coming in like crazy, and I know people hate when I say like crazy.
Was it a technical glitch?
I have no idea. What do you got on that, Than?
That was not XM's mistake.
Oh.
That was whoever set up the board this morning did not have a certain button to press that sends stuff from, you know, certain things to, over to XM.
Wait a minute, so XM did not screw up. Who's
way to make me look bad.
Sorry, but...
Ah, screw XM anyway. For other things that you know.
Wait, was that you who didn't hit the thing? Or was,
no,
you
not I didn't. No,
who set the board up?
Please,
there?
Jimmy, please.
The gentleman who normally does it is not in today.
So so what is? Are they going to be able to hear it on that side?
Yeah, the button got pushed and now it's fine.
What button?
Utility button.
Oh, right.
So on the replay, I'm thinking we'll add it in.
We'll fix it.
Fix it.
All right, all right,
great. Just fix it.
Well, I think that XM is owed something.
I'm never wrong. I stand by what I said. Oh, they're... Oh.
This one was on us. XM didn't do it. It was us.
And, blame they're me. Wrong about something.
They are.